This is a head cannon circus duction.
Job, but for this other stuff is for relaxation.
Yeah. Hey, what's going on, people? Once again, you are back with the Gladiator Cypher Podcast, a Heaux Tales Circus production. That's your boy Chris, aka Scribe, aka Pseudonym Slim, coming at you. Got my two bros with me. Go ahead, introduce yourself, Nip.
Oh, yeah, you know, Big Nip, Big Papa Bear Nip, you know, Mr. Pass Me Another One. You know, Mr. You think everything's funny, shit. You know what I'm
saying? We gotta add another one to it. We made the call your microphone shorty now. I heard you got a little,
We got a little something popping off you over here. Up. Check a 1-2. Don't be surprised. My mixtape dropping next week. You know what I'm saying?
We're gonna down your microphone, Poppy.
Fat backs and flapjacks. That's the mixtape album. That's the title.
That's funny. And finally, last but not least, got my cousin Jason. Go ahead.
What's going on? Hey, look, don't ever let me follow Nip like that. Fuck that. Now I gotta figure out some funny shit to say, and I ain't got nothing for it, man. Always introduce me first. Fuck that.
We'll take that for the next episode. But just jumping right into it, we had a nice R&B release by the super talented super skillful Jazmine Sullivan, dropping her project, Heaux Tales. Apparently, this is not an album by Jazmine. She's calling this an EP. But to me, it felt like an album, personally. And just to start off, I would say I really like the project. I think the songs on there were written pretty well. All the features were dope. I especially liked her song with Ari Lennox. That was an awesome song.
I want you.
And yeah, she's just really showing off her skill. I definitely picked up a different vibe than some of her past projects. You know, we get a lot of like sad Jazmine or kind of heartbroken. This one, she's kind of on her own, you know what I mean? Doing what she want to do. So I enjoyed it. How'd you guys feel about the project by Jazmine?
Yeah, nah, man. I mean, I thought it was dope. It, I'm going to keep it real. I was surprised how good it was. The only drawback, I think, like you said, now makes sense if she's saying it's an EP. Mm-hmm. Makes perfect sense because it was 30 minutes and then half the songs are skits, mm-hmm. which I think the skits do add influence to the song. So it worked well, but that was my only critique was like, I could have probably took an extra 20 more minutes. Mm-hmm. It would have been straight like with that amount because the skits were in between. But I'm like you, man. I mean, Jazmine Sullivan, she came with a kind of this the new style that these R&B singers are doing, but mm-hmm. she still stayed in that earlier Missy pocket that she came out with early in there. And like I always tell you on the show, if you give me vocal layers and mm-hmm. it's the artist doing the layers, you're going to sell me every time because that is such a hard thing to do, to hit every single note and make it clean and crisp like that. So I thought the theme of the album, the Heaux Tales, and I'm suggesting everybody go listen to this album. I mean, I think it's a quick listen, but she blew it out the water, man. She blew it Acapulco. What is that? Blew it Acapulco. Blew it out.
Yeah, all that music shit is cool. It's finna be a whole lot of babies running around this motherfucker. And September, let me tell you something. They're on it, joint.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, that's sir. That's the one. I was finna fire off on that. Somebody's finna get it.
Torpedoes away.
Right.
Somebody leaving pregnant, huh?
Somebody catch yourself.
Also, I mean, you know what's dope too on there? This is an album that I probably can't think of too many albums in my hand in recent memory that you can have like real dope ass knockout drag out arguments with friends, especially from the opposite sex, mm-hmm. off of this album. Because out of those skits, they set up a lot of conversation.
Speaking of, like, what was one of the skits that kind of really you maybe had strong feelings for, maybe disagreed or really strongly agreed?
Oh, mine. I mean, I don't know how everybody feel, but me being a married man, mm-hmm. when they said these motherfuckers that be married be hoeing too, it was like, because you want your man to do this, so you do this, and you get like, I said, you know what? She ain't lying. I done got broke off some good stuff sometimes. And they be like, hey, baby, we should probably go ahead and pay for this. I'm like, man, just put it on the card. I don't care. I'm trying to roll over.
It's socially accepted. It's socially accepted to drop it off and get your kitchen done. But we shaming them for get the 40, right? The same thing. I got 40 for them.
There you go. 40. That's funny. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Yeah. It was definitely a good project. I'm looking forward to some more solid R&B releases this year in 2021. But musically, I'm not mad at it.
Question for you. Could y'all hear the Ari skit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. I couldn't on Tidal, it wouldn't let me play it. And I had to like go listen on like I think I listened to it on like YouTube or mm-hmm. Spotify or something. Well, came back to the album.
So do we speculate that the person she's talking about may be working at Tidal?
Yeah, because she was talking about, you know, being with somebody toxic, but the sex was so good, it was just kind of keeping her there. And she was like, if y'all Googled him or whatever, you know, she's like, I know what Google says, but I also know that this is giving me life, all this kind of stuff. So that's a good theory. That's a good headcanon Gladiator Cypher theory right there. We're going to chalk that as the first theory of 2021. Whatever. See how so that plays out.
Be giving her life. Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't fuck a lot in my life. I'm going to keep it 100. I ain't trying to brag, but yeah. I ain't never had a broad tell me my dick gave her life. Now to put life inside of a broad. But I ain't never had my dick give her life.
Yeah, I don't know. I done had a few scrapes with some aggression after, you know what I mean? You take the D away. And so I done had a couple cars keyed up, some lights bust out with bats, some fake babies, some fake sonograms and shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying I'm on that level. I'm just saying, you know, shit happens, you know, shit, maybe I've been fishing in the wrong pond, but I didn't
we need a spinoff show, just the Adventures of Nip.
Really, that's gonna be the marquee title.
It gets a little wild in the '20s, baby. That the 20s story gets a little crazy. Hey. Big sidebar about that situation. So when the shit was going down, right? So I calls the police on the bitch, right? So I go down to the police station. I'm like, yo, shorty just hit my shit with a bat. Like, can I get a restraining order, a motherfucking stay away? They like, oh, nah, we can't do that for you. And all the officers is laughing. Like, this is a funny. Then I had to go downtown. I'm like, yo, can I get a stay away? Or they're like, nah, we can't. You're not in imminent danger.
Damn.
Crazy,
man. Man, but look, it's all full circle, right? Jazmine Sullivan, bust the windows out your car.
Windows in the car. Now, if I was out here breaking windows, they had my black ass locked up.
Sound like a whole lot of drama. And speaking of drama, we got even more drama between two hip hop legends. Again, Snoop and Eminem going back at it. I believe Eminem was in a recent interview talking about his feelings regarding Snoop's comments. To Snoop ranking him, you know, telling him he's not really in his top 10 because he can't mess with some people, you know, in the 80s and the 90s and whatnot. And it sounded like Eminem was upset because of Snoop's tone.
So Eminem addressed that on the track Zeus. He said, and as far as squashing beef, I'm used to people knocking me, but just not in my camp. And diplomatic as I'm trying to be, last thing I need is Snoop dogging me. Man, dog, you was like a damn god to me. Nah, not really. I had dog backwards.
Him saying Dre made the best version of me, absolutely. Like if would I be here without Dre? No. KRS-One, Big Daddy Kane, G-Rap, like I've never said I could with them. I think it was more about the tone he was using that caught me off guard, because I'm like, yo, where is this coming from? I just saw you, like, what the f-? Again, I probably could have got past the whole tone and everything, but it was the last statement when he said, as far as music I can live without, I can live without that shit. Now you're being disrespectful for, like, it just caught me off guard.
So trying to police the great Snoop Dogg's tone in the interview. How do you gentlemen feel about that?
Hey, man.
Y'all
already know how I feel about Vanilla Ice Tea. I can't fake us. Like, I don't care nothing about what you're talking about, bro. You're not in my top 10. I don't know. Like, and then he's talking about, like, oh, your tone. What are we talking about here? You expect a guy that started rapping in the 80s or maybe the 90s and arguably one of the best hip hop albums of all time to put you in your top, Mr. Slim Shady.
Mm-hmm. And then you get buttered.
You should be out of the top 10 based off of your 8 Mile movie lyrics. That's what I'm saying. Lotto, I don't fit you. Shut your ass up.
Cheddar Bob.
Yeah.
Hey, okay, man. We're not going to sit here and desecrate 8 Mile, bro. Slow down. It's Breaking. It's The Last Dragon. And then it's 8 Mile, bro. Slow down, man.
Whoa. We can't put 8 Mile in the same category as The Last Dragon. That's what
Look here, man. Mm-mm. Stop it. Don't desecrate 8 Mile, man. I know you ain't happy with it, but it had Falcon in it. You
Exhibit,
know what I'm saying?
It had a bunch of people.
So, come on, man. Don't do this. Don't do that to Anthony Mackie. It had Brett locked up. Homeboy.
They were acting their ass off out there in 8 Mile.
Pfeiffer, like, come on now. Slow down.
Them Cypher rhymes was kind of booty.
Papa Doc.
Hey, look, but I'm gonna be real. I'm with you. Like, now you, for the first time, I felt like Eminem came off. First time that we have, like, in recent time, because I know he did the whole N-word and talking about black women thing back in the day, which we kind of glossed over and forgave him for to a degree. But for the first time, I felt like Eminem got on his white privilege and was like, oh, I mean, you're gonna tell me that, like, you know, my songs can be forgettable or not, or you know, won't. And like Eminem's tone at that point was on some white privilege. How dare this black man say this about me and my songs and my music? And I get it, Eminem. I mean, like an artist, you know what Erykah Badu say? You know, I'm
you
an artist.
You just about your shit, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And I get it, Em, and I understand that. But you came off almost Joe Biden-esque. Like, how dare you say that to me, white? You know, black guy, and me being a white man. And it felt that way to me when he was like, you know, and with Snoop's tone, Snoop can say what the hell he wants.
Mm-hmm.
only person that can check Snoop in this world is his wife and his mama. Mm-hmm. Everybody else need to go to hell.
I will shoot him a little bail, like you were saying, you know, when you're an artist, you're kind of sensitive about your things. And then this is somebody kind of from the same camp that you pretty much started your career in. I think that record rumor at this point, if it's not confirmed, I'm not going to really consider it too much. But that would be kind of counterintuitive to his point about them being from the same camp, you know, wanting to show respect about your same camp. Well, I'm like, Snoop is one of, if not probably the biggest rappers ever. So for you to not want to do a song with somebody that came up with the producer that gave you your career and is a certified legend in the game, that seems kind of off-putting to me. And just, I don't know, Eminem in general, it's just like as the years goes on, his legacy kind of gets more and more tarnished. You know, I feel like he's just dropping further down the list each year. While he's supremely talented, you know, I don't think he's all that at the end of the day. I mean, I'm a fan of some of his songs, but like we've said on last week, I don't think he's top five material.
We've seen his battle, his best battle bars on 8 Mile.
Oh, why you 8 Mile, bro? Why you killing 8 Mile? You already watched the movie now, and I'm gonna send you some of them bars, bro. His mom's was getting spaghetti, bro. I'm gonna send you all of them.
I do live in a trailer park with my mom.
You're gonna be like, I know something that you don't know. Like, see, I'm gonna give you all the verses, bro, when we get off here, man.
Did something else that was quite entertaining during this release, and also features, you know, two legends going at it, but this time more collaboratively and not so much in a conflict. We got Watch the Throne. So we spoke about this a little bit last week on last week's episode of Gladiator Cypher Podcast. Mm-hmm. So we got, you know, our two very opinionated co-hosts, got Nip and Jay, about to duke it out. We're going track by track to figure out who exactly won on Watch the Throne. I'm gonna go ahead and kick it off with Jay, starting off with track one.
All right, first of all, I want to say that shout out to my moderator Chris, you know, Pseudonym Slim, you know, Pseudonym Slim out here. He about to moderate this for us because we gonna have some conflicts in here. But all right, let me pull up the track list here, and then when you disagree, Nip, jump in there and tell me why I'm wrong, and we go from there. So
yes, sir.
Starting off with No Church in the Wild.
Mm-hmm.
I got Jay-Z for No Church in the Wild.
I think you're high. You're smoking crack rocks. Kanye smoking on No Church in the Wild.
Come on, man.
When Jay first came in, I'm like, oh yeah, Jay might have this. Nah. Nah.
What does Kanye fuck with? What I'm wondering if a thug's prayers reach is pious, pious as God loves pious. Socrates asks, whose bias do y'all seek? I'm off of Plato screech. I'm out here balling. I know you hear my nothing that Ye says can fuck with any of that, man. The pious on pious not alone, like God loves pious. What? No, and it's close on that one. I'll admit, when Church of the Wild, I was like, yeah, I felt the same way, but I'm like, nah, like Jay dropped so many jewels, and that's just one of the jewels on it. He dropped so many jewels on it. See, the hardest thing about this competition, the hardest thing with this competition is what we talked about the week before with Kanye. Kanye lyrics and rhymes are so straightforward that you get them. But Jay's, a lot of these lines that Jay hit, once you hear it out loud, you go, oh, shit. I didn't even realize he dropped the ball like that. Like, once you hear it out loud, that's why I feel like it's always going to be hard. Because Ye lines, it's some shit that Ye say that's just, it make you feel good.
Man, like, I need that provocative shit. When he talk about coke on a blast skin, make a stripe like a zebra. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the bathroom. I'm
right there with
him. You hear me? You know what I'm saying? I'm right there.
You call that jungle fever.
Come on, bro. Just roll the weed up. Let me get me some. You know what I'm saying? We for a new religion.
That's what got your car fucked up talking like that.
As long as there's permission. Come on, bro. I need that strength. I need that. And the flow was off. Talking that God is pious, but pious. Like, come on now. The flow was off, dog.
Hold on, but the song is No Church for the Wild. Like, the song is talking about the whole thing that he's hitting on. Yeah, you just talked about it Saturday night.
All right. I'm still going right, Kanye. I like the provocative verse, but I will admit Jay's verse was better on that one than I originally thought it was when I off the listen back.
you know, in this case, I'm gonna have to give the slight edge to Hov for track one. I don't think he blew Ye out the water, because like you said, Ye brings that bravado and he's just like, hey, this is what it is. You know, I'm not going to decorate it with all the flowers and the simile metaphor, all the monopoeia, all that kind of stuff, but he kind of just gives it to you.
We're just going to overlook Love is Cursed by Monogamy? That's the hardest bar in this song. We just going to overlook
nobody without telling me. That's what I'm saying. Like, he don't kill it at the end. Love is Cursed by Monogamy. Don't fuck nobody without telling. Like, and then he hits you with last night was mad real. Like, come on, man.
Like, sunglasses and everything. You don't know that feeling. You don't know that feeling of sniffing coke off a bungee and you hung up. You know what I'm saying? You got to pop that Advil, get your sunglasses on. You know what I'm saying? Driving back home, 7:30 in the morning. You know what I'm saying?
You right about that one. Good night. Oh my goodness.
Oh my right. God.
So we're gonna keep this rolling. We're gonna keep this rolling. Let's move on.
Liftoff is the next one. I went Ye with Liftoff. I think Jay ain't put nothing into Liftoff at all.
Yeah, probably, but I just wrote Skip. I'm not listening to that. I don't give a fuck. Who won that?
That is the weakest song on the album.
Huh?
It is the weakest song on the song of the album by far.
It is a horrible fuck, like, not horrible song, but I'm not listening to that. Who that was Beyonce singing on that shit, right?
Yeah.
I'm
cool. I don't care who we say on that one. I didn't even rank that one. I just wrote Skip.
Yeah, I felt like JayZ was like, well, since Beyonce singing, I only got to give like 8 bars on this song.
Right.
I ain't mad.
But I went Ye on that one. So I guess we're in agreement with Ye then with Liftoff then.
Okay. That's fine. Yeah.
All right. Next up, one of the singles, Niggas in Paris.
Oh, yeah, I went Ye on that.
So you went Ye on Niggas in Paris?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, because he got the most memorable shit on there with the whole. Yeah, I mean, he had a whole summer motherfuckers talking about fish fillet. Like, I can't fuck with that. No matter how much I want to justify, I can't. You know, and then, you know, if you know, what was it? I would have married Kate and Ashley. Like, the Austin twin reference, that's right. Just.
I had it as Ye, and then I had kind of like a cross tie. Because it wasn't a whole lot of, like, hard, like, hitting lyrics in there. I think he edged him out. I had it / tie in that joint. So
no, and I agree, but I just think, you know, the impact of that song, what people will remember that song for 50 years from now will be that fish fillet line. And I mean, that's just, I can't really say shit about that one. So I guess we got JayZ 1, Ye 2 so far.
Exactly. I give it to Ye 2. It's memorable. Like you said, I could still hear him coming in on that one.
I feel like we're about to have a fight right now.
Uh-oh. Here we go. Otis.
Okay. All right.
Give it to me.
You already know who I'm going with.
All right, next song is Otis.
You already know.
Who is it?
It's Ye, baby. Ye smoked him on Otis.
Hey, look. Because, you know, I look at these rap battles like boxing matches. The first knockdown just happened. Kanye just knocked down Jay-Z on Otis. That's 2 points in that round for me, for Kanye.
For Otis, right?
Yeah. For Otis, yeah. That's yes, 2 points for Ye on that one. Like, he knocked down Jay with that one. I can't fake. I can't front. I mean, just to let alone Maybach sneaker read, what would Hov do? Like, I mean, you know, ignorant, you know, what was it? Ignorant curses, right? My verses. Yeah, like, it's just,
yes, sir. He was all over his ass on that drink.
Yeah, I can't. There's an issue, though. If you're Jay-Z, that was like the lead single, Quasi, because, you know, Hammond came out earlier, but for the official lead single, that was Otis. Why you let yourself get smoked like that on a lead single?
Yeah.
Right. Right.
That's what I heard. That song at that point, I was like, oh shit. Maybe I didn't know. Like, you can't get smoked on a lead single like that. Like, I don't even remember a Jay line on that. Like, all the lines on that I remember is just straight from Ye. Like, I guess the only thing I remember on Otis was not bad for some immigrants. We digging tunnels right up under you. Like, you know, I'm like, okay, that was cool, Jay. But I mean, nah. You're not gonna fuck with the rest of that stuff. So nah, I mean, yeah. Oh, I'm gonna give Ye 2 points for that. So right now I got it. Kanye 4, Jay-Z 1.
Okay.
All right. I'm in total agreement. Let's move on to Gotta Have It.
Gotta Have It, man. I'm going Jigga.
I'll give it to him. Okay, your mummy back. Mummy rap. I said, okay. I said, okay.
What the motherfucker? Where my money at? You going to make me come down to your house? Where your mommy at?
Yeah.
Mommy rap the kids. Have them crying for their mommy back. I'm like, yeah, Jay got it.
I said, as soon as I heard the mummy shit, I said, okay, all right, you got it.
You got it, big fella.
You got it.
But it wasn't even a smoking. Like, Ye still gets off on that shit. Like,
he does, but you can't, yeah. He should have put that verse on Otis or some shit. Because he tore Ye ass up on that joint.
So I got Jay-Z 2, Kanye 4 going into New Day. I had New Day as a draw. I don't feel like neither one of them really... They got into a sentimental bag, and I feel like I can't disregard either one of their stories on that one.
Yeah. I was like, I don't even like listening to that song. I have it as a tie. It's not a bad song. I don't have it as a skip, but it's too emotional, dog. It's like, yeah, I'm cool on that. But it's definitely a draw.
Chris, you lean any way on that one? Or you?
No, it's kind of like in the middle for me, like you all said. Neither one of them did enough to make me sway on one side or the other. So I agree with you all on that one.
I like Kanye's shit more because of the I'm going to pinpoint everything negative about myself and make sure that my son isn't coming up like that. So I dig that. Like, that son and shit, you see that shit in him. And, you know, my son, he only fucking 2, 3, whatever, but he's definitely a little asshole and shit, so. Try to wean that out. He's definitely not going to be a Republican, so we can like white people. We not doing that.
We should have saw the signs then, man.
Yeah.
I know he was dropping.
And I'm with you on New Day. I think it's a draw. I think, like you said, I like the way Ye's verse flew through a story of like, yeah, like I'm trying to make sure I raise a better child. I think Jay's verse is more of I didn't have a father, but I got money. So I'm gonna make sure you understand how the money thing goes. I think even he was saying like having a drink with his son at 13, like cutting the time in half or whatever like that. So, but I think it was a draw. I don't think it's much there. I think the next one is That's My Bitch. I got that one as a draw too, man. I don't think I felt like either one of them actually slammed that one. That could be like, all right, we got that.
I got that as Jay. Hold on, let me see what I got down here. I got that as Jay, but
Give me what you got on that one then.
I'm not mad at the draw. What was the line?
Don't give me no. I paid for them titties. Get your own.
Like,
that shit is cool as shit to say, but that shit don't mean nothing.
You're right. No. Not trying to be literal. But my dick is money. I put money in the middle. Come on, bro. I know it's base. I know it's popcorn, but that shit was all right.
Yeah, he has some good stuff.
I know it's what. That's what it was like. I like the provocative shit.
Yeah, Twisted Love Story, True Romance, Mary Magdalene from a Pole Dance.
And that's why I was waiting next. I'm like, okay, those two lyrics, I was like, that's dope. But then I look at Jay's joint, it's like, back to my Beyonce, you deserve three stacks, word to Andre, call Larry. But it's like, it's some things in there, but he's, the problem is in this one, like, Jay actually was with Beyonce. So he had to kind of be on that one. But also, I like the whole, you belong with niggas who known for dealing dope. You too dope for any of those civilians. Now shoot children, stop looking at her titties. Get your own bitch. You heard that? I mean, get your own dog. You heard? That's my bitch. Like, I feel like that's why I had it as a draw now. I think we need to go to a decision on that one because.
I'm going to have to. I'll give it to Jay on that one. Slightly. Actually, I'm kind of in the middle. I can't even really do that because I like
I feel you. It's a hard one. The only reason why I say yay is because, like, you come with a song, the title of the song is That's My Bitch. Like, I'm just thinking we going on some, like, we just not goofy, but like we talking shit.
Yeah.
And they come in and talk about, like, hey man, why ain't no black women up here getting revered the same as these white? You come in right to space. Like, nigga, that's what we talk about here. I'm trying to bring the drinks and the cocoa, baby. What are we doing here? Why we ain't talking about my girl with Marilyn Monroe?
Yeah.
On, okay. Because of that, I will give you that. Because I did use for Church of the Wild. No Church of the Wild. I used topic. I will concede to give Ye that point because topically, Ye was more on the topic of That's My Bitch. So I'm gonna concede that one. If it's okay with the moderator, I'll concede that point.
All right.
We'll stay with the theme, baby. Stay with the theme.
All right, next up we got Welcome to the Jungle.
I didn't count it because it's pretty much a Jay-Z song. Like, Ye has
I have Jay Default on here. Like, yeah, it's a Jay-Z song.
Yeah. Agreed. After that, we got Who Gonna Stop Me.
Same thing on that.
I went Jay because of the end. That's purely the only reason I had Jay. All through the song, I was like, oh, Jay about to fuck this over. Yeah. And then he went spaz at the end, and I was like, all right, good. I secured this one.
Yeah, I got the same thing. Jay Default.
All right, we get a point to Jay-Z. Next up, we got Made in America.
Well, we skipped one.
Oh, we did? Murder to Excellence, my bad.
There you go.
Oof.
Uh-huh. You know what it is. Hardest one, man. You know what it is.
Let me look this up.
This is my hardest one.
You know what it is. Oh. Boy, give it to him.
I gave it a draw, man.
Nah.
That's my hardest one, bruh.
Nah. No, sir.
No shop class. Half the school got a tool. That Ye versus hard, boy.
That's
I was like,
I'm saying.
But then Jay hit him with the in a sheepskin coats. I silence of the lambs. Do you know who I am, Clarice?
Clarice, like, yeah.
That was a tough one, bro.
I gave that one to Ye, bro. I ain't gonna hold you. We're gonna have to go moderator
on that one.
I'm gonna give it to Jay. I'm not Jay, but Kanye on that one.
Okay.
And he had the Black Murder Chicago lines, and that was when Chicago was hot.
Like, yeah,
still is. I don't know if it ever cooled off.
I don't think it came down too much. Yeah, I gave that one a yay. I ain't gonna lie. That was Jay.
That's where that emotion works in his favor, right?
Right.
His ability to kind of deliver his vibe to the listener, you know, just based on production, based on, you know, the energy behind his voice. Jay, you know, technically might be saying colder stuff, but it's just some of the emotion that Kanye evokes in you. It kind of really shown on this track.
Well, and the reason I get it, and that's the thing, because Ye's energy, you can feel it through the lyrics, but Jay ain't never been an energy rapper, so I always have to get it there. Because, I mean, let's be real, really the hardest line on the whole joint is, I survived on the day Fred Hampton died. Real niggas multiply. And they say before me, I'm supposed to die. So I'm out here celebrating my post-demise. Like,
That was the hardest part. Hands down. Hands down is the hardest part of the song.
It ain't said with no kind of impact. Like, you'll miss it if you're not paying attention.
Yeah,
exactly.
And boy, everything he says lands because he makes sure you hit and he hits every single bar clean. Like, I'll concede. I mean, if y'all gonna go yay on that one, so right now what we got the score is coming up. It's coming up short for me. Let's see. We had Jay 1, 2. I think we got Jay at 3.
Got 3. Yeah.
Kanye's 1, 2, 3, 4, because I counted Otis twice. 4, and then this one's 5. And then you decided that's my bitches, yay?
Yeah, no, you said, we did say that's my bitches, yay.
Yeah,
okay. because he didn't stick to the theme, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So let me change that in my scores so I can make sure I have that right. Actually does it right. So okay, so we got what yay 6 right now then, right?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay, shit. I may be running out of songs now.
Next up we got Made in America.
Really, the star is Frank Ocean.
That's what I got. And I got Skip because I'm not listening to that shit.
I did put Jay's versus Nasty on it though. But I mean Frank Ocean overshines the whole song, so I don't even I think the only lyric I had for Jay was what was the joint? I feel like this was a cold one because this is when Jay-Z does the whole grandma theme on it.
And I feel like
that was dope as hell. I pledge allegiance to my grandma for the banana pudding. I place Americana, you know, blah, blah. And he goes, she goes, what's that? He's like, you know, what's that smell? I'm just boiling some agua. Like, yeah, it's some just dope shit on there.
Yeah.
No papa, bad Santa. The streets raised me. Pardon my bad manners. Like Jay-Z got some killers on there, man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he does have some nice lines on there. But I didn't know my arm was in the shot. he loses me with that old man Jay-Z flow. I just can't. This is like I don't know. This might have been the album that was the start of that. Where I was just like, it's hard. Like the bars are hard. The content is good, but it's like. It's no pop to it. It's no fire behind it.
I'm shocked you don't like this one because this is straight D-boy cooking in the kitchen, like our apple pie was supplied through the Arm & Hammer.
Yeah, but there's no feelings to it.
Right. It, I mean,
no feeling, bro. It's like,
it still stands. It's like I'm trying Frank to lead a nation to leave my little man. Like, it's so...
It, like I said, the bars, the content, I fucks with it, but it's like, it's like flat Sprite, bro. It's like, ah, this shit. I'm gonna drink it because I'm thirsty, but this shit don't hit the.
This is not hitting.
I don't get that in there. Nah.
It's not that McDonald's.
Yeah, that ain't McDonald's Sprite. No, oh, that shit Sierra Miss. Don't give it a Sierra Miss, cuz.
Oh, my God. Well, I guess we go to the bottom, right? Because I think you got nobody in it, but I'm taking Jay. But I feel like Jay is the only thing that had verses on there, at least.
Yeah.
I don't even remember Ye verse on this one.
Nah. Yeah, he's just, he has a verse on there.
I think he was like at the bridge or some shit.
Yeah, he's like, I told my mom I was on a come up. She said, you're going to go to school. I'll give you a summer. And then he kind of goes in a little bit. I'm looking at the lyrics now. I don't even remember his verse like that.
Exactly. Yeah, you can have it if you want to. I don't listen to that fucking song. I don't.
All right, what's the next one, Chris?
All right, we got Why I Love You.
That was another basically Jay-Z song, so I didn't even rake it.
Skip.
Pretty much, yeah.
I didn't even skip from that shit. Why am I listening to these fucking songs?
Paranoid.
Yeah, right. I skip.
Next up, we got Illest Motherfucker Alive.
Okay, now, I know I said the early one's the hardest one. This song right here is if you put them both in the ring and they just both gave they best shots. Because you can go line by line on this one. They both just go sick on this one. I went Jay-Z by 2 points on this one because he got some shit on this that is just so fucking gangster. Like, I mean, you know, this one would have been like if Carlito never went back. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, this is how the end of the Scarface should have been. Like, it's some, Jay got some crazy shit on Ill Motherfucker Alive, man. Illest Motherfucker Alive. But... Ye got some good ones too.
Like I never put on here.
Shout out to Ye for put me on the Naomi Russell. Like bulletproof condom when I'm in these hoes.
Yeah,
that staples on my dick. Why I fucking centerfolds? Like,
oh man, uh-oh.
1985 white Lamborghini Countach, two of them. I need a slow motion video right now. Cause I'm moving in slow motion, slow motion. Feeling like Pipe Williams shooting a nigga, pooping a nigga. Hey, hey, hey. I need a slow motion video right now. Hey, hey. Damn, baby, pussy can't be your only hustle. Unless you bad as Naomi Russell. I mean, a lot of niggas got money. So basically, Russell ain't the only Russell. Russell Brand, Russell Crowe. 0000, a whole lot of O's. What you after? After money? You in line behind currency. Yeah, you after money. Bulletproof condom when I'm in these hoes. Got staples on my dick. Why? Fucking centerfolds. And I swear to God, they so cold. Got a nigga in Miami wearing winter clothes. I got my fur on, feeling like Jerome. She got a fur too, we get eyes in her on. Don't look at the jewelry or get your blur on. Too close to comatose. So dope, you overdose. Get back, you over close. Load, oh, a hood of sun, and then I bless them with that polo. Niggas is making music, and then my first solo. Colo Jolo, sponsored by Manolo. TKZ Epinodos, ready for some photos. Yeah, and I'm cold, bitch, please try to keep the door closed. Line by $1,000 tee with no logos. Let me show you what I see when my eyes close.
Take it how you want to, a nigga dead.
I'm the illest motherfucker alive.
Yeah, yeah. Whole world aiming at a nigga head.
Because I'm the illest motherfucker alive.
Yeah, yeah. Hold up, Ken Ho, I'm exactly what the fuck you think.
Eddie Murphy's couch. The rock is in the building, we should have stayed in the house. I don't even know what we doing here. Seems to be a complete waste of gear. Just a fucking waste of time, a complete waste of bottles. Niggas fashion is weak, they be wasting all the models. Got the oversized rollie, let me show thee how to do it. I say it, then you see it, it ain't only in the music. Basquiat's, Warhol's, serving as my muses. My house like a museum, so I see him when I'm peeing. Usually you have this much taste, you European. That's the end of that way of thinking, nigga, never again. Know when to leave when the heat is coming, I learned that. This is where De Niro would be if he ain't turned back. Fuck Sosa, this Hova, this is real life. This is what the end in the Scarface should feel like. I need a slow motion video right now, 'cause I'm a winner. Slow motion, feeling like hype when shooting a nigga, scooping a nigga. Hey, hey, hey. I need a slow motion video right now. Slow motion, hey, hey. Slow motion, slow motion.
Hey, baby, pussy can't be your only hustle unless your dad is the only wrestle. Come on, cut. In the intro, that comes out the endless motherfucker alive.
Oh, man, it didn't go off.
It goes off.
But that's what I'm saying. But even JayZ got the 11 in a row, Bill Russell rings, Michael Jordan swag. Y'all think Michael Jordan bad? Nigga, I got 5 more rings than Michael Jordan had. Elvis left the building, and now I'm on the Beatles' ass. Niggas here watch the throne, yeah, like the Beatles back. Like, Bebe, my Yoko Ono, Riri, my complete the family. Like, again, this is probably the match where if they both got in the middle of the ring and you was like, nobody flinched, just go buck for buck.
Yeah.
Fuck your wars like Eddie Murphy's couch. Like, come on, man.
If we call it a draw, I won't be mad at it.
I might have to call it a draw because they both, like,
man, Jay gets some nasty knocks on it. Remember, the song is Illest Motherfucker Alive. And I know Ye is talking about some ill shit, but Jay's talking that ill shit that we can relate to, man. You, how you go your Eminem thing? That's what I feel like. If Jay talking that ill shit, we can relate to, man.
That's true. That's true.
We.
But I think I may be going two. If I'm going 2 points, I'll concede Jay winning just by 1 point then.
Okay, 1 point. Yeah, I'll do the 1 point. All right. I can't get with the two. But I'll give it 1 point on
there. I'll give it up. We'll give Jay the 1 point on there. Fuck it.
All right, and then next up we got Ham, one of the singles.
Ham, I think honestly, because I've heard Ham so much in my life, I almost block it out now when I hear it.
Yeah, I don't like that song.
I had like a draw on this one.
I don't care for Ham. I like Ham. I like pork and shit, but not this fucking song. Like, this shit. I'd rather eat a bacon sandwich and listen to this shit. I'm cool.
Little BLT.
Yeah, I'm cool on him.
All right, we'll go ahead and draw it out then. Next up, we got, let's see.
Prime time?
Yeah, prime time.
You already know what I'm about to say.
God, go ahead. Say what you're going to say.
Yeezy. That's all you can say.
Oh, man. Yeah. Yeah.
It's Ye. It's Ye.
I mean, and for only one reason, because, you know, sometimes, because when I rate these songs, I go, all right, who had the hardest hitting line? Then I go, who delivered the shit the best? Who stayed on theme with the art, you know, blah, blah, blah. That whole, well, Adam gave up a rib, so mom better be prime. Oh, my
yes,
God.
Yes, sir. That was it.
Oh, my God.
That was it. Damn, Yeezy, they all got to be dimes. Yes, sir. That's it.
Every single one of them.
Oh, my. You know what? Because Jay got some stuff in there. But
Jay,
like,
yeah, his verses is all the numbers.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's crazy. And I think he only repeats 23. That's the only number that he repeats, and he only does that once. Everything else is.
Yeah, and I'm saying, like, the Jay's verses are rapper heavy, but we talk about the same thing is always hard with this is Ye give you all the punchlines and the shit that we can just we feel, but if you want to be a rapper, Jay's was killing it. That's why I said I can't, but I did concede and go Ye on it just because of that Adam line, that prime rib joint. That's hard. All the great shit Jay-Z put on that, he didn't say one thing that was harder than that.
No, and it's just like the same. So this is my beef, not beef, with my thing with the Watch the Throne drink. A lot of his verses, especially the good ones, it's all money talk. And I get it, I respect it, but it's, come on, Kyle, we got to talk about, give me the Z.
Hold on. Not the guy that listens to the elder when we're talking straight Hustle Boy talk all day. When you listen to a Jay-Z album, that's what you're going to get. It's going to be jiggy. It's going to be flashy. It's going to be money. It's going to be swag talk. Like, that's like, – yeah, you can't fault him for being that guy. He's so successful.
Yeah, you're right. But give me.
You can't listen to Pusha T because all Pusha T talk about is pushing.
Yeah, but you got to be more – you got to make it more colorful.
What? You got to make it more colorful. And that I will say, like – Pushes, like you were saying, like the street talk, it's, you know what he's going to give you every song, but it's the way he delivers it, like the schemes colorful. And stuff I'm he comes there. Out with. And Pushes be getting hype on some of his tracks, like the Ric Flair, woo, he start going off. I'm like, okay, yeah, he getting in his bag. But Hov, sometimes he's just so kind of like, cool right, for school.
Hey, I know you got money, let me get my hustle up. They go, all right, cool.
Damn, I know, all right, Hov. I know I'm broke too. Hov, like, my 401k straight, Hov. Okay, let me work on it.
Let me check my shit. Let me check my investments. Let me get a spade and put my button up on.
Yeah. Damn, I can't do auto-tune. I can't wear a throwback. What else? Come on, Hov.
Look here, man. Hov, just remember, I ain't say none of this, Hov. When you hear this, blasphemy, Hov. Just make sure, you know what I'm saying?
You can't call on Kanye.
You know, Hov, I was with you. I'm a whole venture like Joe Button and them. So I'm just letting you know, Hov. I'll have your back, man. I don't know.
Kanye don't have our back. He might send Jeffrey to
come out. Oh, shit.
What the problems with the rock, bro?
Yo,
I stopped drinking champagnes because the rock told me stop drinking them champagnes. So, damn. Well, I guess without any declare, I guess from the scoring, Ye officially is the winner of Watch the Throne, the Watch the Throne Challenge. Mm-hmm. I'm taking this hearty L. Now, I'm a do what the responsible adult would do and take the loss and not tell you that it was cheating and voter fraud and secret ballots came in late. I'm just going to take the L like a responsible adult.
Yes, sir. I feel the same way. That it actually made me go back and listen to some more both of their older albums. I went back and listened to the Kanye, the College Dropout. I went back and listened to Blueprint 2. I don't test the volumes, but we ain't got to talk about that. I know we disagree about the volumes.
Oh, here we go.
I ain't going to do it.
Why you can't leave it alone, man? Like, damn,
all right, I'm out. I ain't going to do it. I went back and listened to it. Blueprint.
Just because you don't touch the volumes, what's the best volume then?
It's got to be volume one. They progressively got worse.
Oh,
with three being the worst. Three is the worst volume, bro. I can't believe you're not gonna tell me three is not the worst volume.
I agree. Chris, any input on this one on the volumes?
I gotta go back and listen. It's been so long since I heard those. I can't give a good opinion on this. Somebody's gonna kill me.
We're gonna schedule that for another offshoot. We're gonna have a debate about volume one through three, but I'm gonna say volume two is the best one. I mean, you get Reservoir Dogs on that. You get a couple of Money Cash Holes on that one.
That's Jigga What? Jigga What? Jigga Who was on that shit too?
Hey, that should go off. Yeah,
that's hard. That Timbo on the beat. Oh man, come on.
Yeah, you gotta stop that nip.
Reservoir Dogs is volume two. And he got smoked. And he got smoked by beans and sauce.
Fuck yeah!
Which proved was further last week. Proved my point from last week.
Reformed Jay Z hater. Remember I said that last week, guys. Keep that in mind when you're listening to this. And this is a reformed Jay Z hater.
Roll the footage.
That's all when the volumes, when we were growing up, that's all when volume 1 and 2 and 3 came out.
Yeah,
he hated JayZ.
Hey, we're going to table this. Look, this is going to be our first exclusive content for the people that join the circus, our ringleaders. This is going to be our first special little tidbit of content. We're going to go ahead and rank the volumes by none other than Heaux. So look forward to that one.
Yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to do that one. All right, man. Okay, again, shout out to Nip. He called it. He told me. Yeah, killed Jay. I'm a ride with that.
I think this win's got an asterisk, though.
Whoa, why is that?
Was it because of COVID in the bubble?
No, man. You got to just think, like, did Ye have help? Was this all him solo?
Oh, man. Here we go. Here we go.
Ooh. Do I smell a segue coming? Do I sense a segue about people who have ghostwriters?
My connection's going bad. I don't know. What'd y'all say? I couldn't hear you. What happened? Ghostwriter, what? Huh? I didn't hear what you said.
We'll save it for another day. Moving right along, one of our favorites, Benny the Butcher. It looks like he's been trying to get a verse from Champagne Poppy, aka Certified Lover Boy himself. Drizzy, how y'all feel about that? Y'all think Benny needs a verse from Dre?
Look, it don't matter what me and you think, Chris. It's all about what Nip think, because we know how you feel about Benny, and we way really know how you feel about Drake.
Mm-hmm.
So how you feel about his cultures clashing? That's what we need to know. Speak on it, Nip.
When it comes to what I want to hear and what I want to listen to, no, I do not want to hear no bullshit-ass Drake verse on some Benny shit. But if I was Benny, I'm getting that fucking Drake verse.
Yeah.
I'm getting it.
By any means.
It's a power move. It's a money move. It's a power move. I don't think there are any women. I'm not going to say any women, but most women don't listen to Benny. It's bald haired beard motherfuckers like me that listen to Benny. He gotta step into another realm. So I think Drake definitely pulls him into that sphere of being like more of a mainstream rapper. I think Conway's King to a God pulled him in there, but Benny hasn't had that mainstream song or project that's put him in there where everybody's listening to him.
Let's play a quick game real quick. Let's name the attributes of a woman that probably listens to Benny the Butcher. I'm going to start off, and I'm going to say more likely than not, they got a baby father in jail or sell dope.
First
attribute for women.
She definitely smokes Black and Miles and drinks Henny straight.
Got some kind of burn mark on an arm or a hand, knife wound, all of the above.
Knife wound, cigarette. She definitely smoked Newport.
When she speaks to you sexy, you feel like you're about to fight her.
Maybe.
Yes. All things that women have probably have attributes of.
And she might work at Waffle House.
Damn.
Oh man, that was a good exercise. I enjoyed that, guys.
That was good.
I hand it back over to you.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. So just moving along, as we begin to wrap up, I wanted to follow up with you all, see if you've been listening to any music this week.
Oh man, our favorite segment. Hey, Chris, what have you been listening to?
Man, I've been listening to a lot. Let me go ahead and pull it up. Thanks to my lovely fiance, she actually has a vinyl player that we've been playing records on. So she went to the store in Laurel. It's a small business. This lady runs it. And she picked up a few different albums. So we ended up listening to Donna Summer's Greatest Hits on vinyl. That was pretty fun. A lot of, you know, disco tracks on there. I was familiar with a lot of them. I didn't know she was a singer on them because, you know, when you're little, rhyme with your parents, you're just hearing all kind of oldies and stuff. You don't really put the names with the songs themselves. So when they come back, oh, okay, you put two and two together. So that was pretty cool. We already spoke about Heaux Tales. Loved it. Definitely recommend you listen to it if you haven't. The Conflicted soundtrack by Griselda. I listened to that earlier this week. It was pretty okay. I would say as far as Griselda projects overall, I don't know if this one it was as strong as some of their other offerings, but I think I might lend that a little bit to it being light on Westside and Conway and Benny, you know, verses on the project. It featured a lot of other artists, which was nice. You know, I saw some other artists on there I might look into, but I kind of wanted to hear a little bit more from the heavy hitters. And I feel like I didn't get that all the way. And then those skits, man, I'm telling you, when this movie dropped, this is going to be like a classic, but for the wrong reasons. So I can't wait to see that. Also checked out a project from a group. So they got a weird name. And this is kind of what stuck out to me when I was looking at the new release list. They call it Viagra Boys.
Say what?
Viagra Boys, the blue pill. So I was like, what the heck kind of music is this? Like, it just made me curious. I'm like, I Googled a band. Apparently, it's a Swedish post-punk rock band. And their latest project is called Welfare Jazz. If you listen to it, it definitely has a punk sound to it. But it was pretty cool. I listened to it with some open ears, and I didn't hate it. I'll say that. So I was pleasantly surprised by that fact, because the name kind of threw me off. I'm like, Viagra Boys, what the hell are they talking about? And then to find out they're from Sweden, I'm like, wow, that's pretty crazy. But also, and then this had to be the highlight of my week, I went back and listened to Pusha T's My Name Is My Name, just because it's been a minute since I heard some Pusha, and man, I love that album. I was so glad I went back and listened to it. Pusha's one of my favorite rappers. Like, I think the fact that he almost handicapped himself with forcing himself to have the same subject matter each song, but always trying to, you know, finding a new unique way to deliver his bars, a unique take on the beat or what have you. Like, it's just, his wordplay is great. He's definitely one of my favorites. And like I said, he kind of separates himself a little bit from Jay. Not saying he's better, but the fact that he can have such intricate rhymes and still deliver with energy and passion, I think it's a profound skill that he has. So definitely looking forward to future projects from Pusha. I will see what's down the pipe. Did you all have any throwbacks you've been listening to in the car and the whip at work?
LL Cool J is hard as hell. Battle any rapper, I don't care. Come on, dog. I'm listening to LL. Right.
I don't care, you tell. I excel. They are bad. Gonna go sell double L, motherfucker.
Bubba said, knock you out. Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. That's all I've listened to all week. Only because of the Freddie Gibbs and the Freddie Gibbs and LL said, I will consider. LL don't want that Freddie Gibbs smoke right now.
Not right now.
Oh, here we go. But what are we doing here, man? What are we doing here, bro?
Right now, LL don't want that Freddie Gibbs smoke. If we talk about 89, 88, Farmers Boulevard, LL, Gibbs don't want that smoke. But LL ain't had a good song since 88. Nah, 94.
What do I gotta do with him battling, though? What do I gotta do with him battling?
I don't think he got it no more.
Man, that was the same shit they said in his last battle. He was ripping motherfuckers' heads off.
Yep.
Yeah,
cannabis going wild.
I think LL would definitely surprise. Like, if he did release a track, he would surprise him.
LL old now. LL don't want no smoke with cannabis. And what happened? Cannabis got his lunch ate.
That was still, when the fuck was that shit? 98?
But when they were saying it, they were saying LL was washed too when that was going on.
20 years ago.
Yo, I would be so shocked and surprised if we heard a track come from LL. Like, just the fact that he put out something, I'm like, he might damn near win it just by dropping a record. Bro. Like, that's because,
right? Freddie tried to rip her, dog. Don't try to rip her like that, bro.
No, bro. You know, LL is in my top five. Like, you know, I'm an LL fan, but now I don't know. I don't know.
I ain't never heard Freddie Gibbs battle nobody except for Academics. And he just talked about playing with his titties. Yeah, that's on the Eminem status of battle.
Yeah, that is. That's punching way down. He act not even a rapper.
Yeah, I don't even make music, let alone rap.
That's true.
Oh my
God. The kids do got that smoke.
You ain't got the wordplay. You got the bars for it, but we see. I don't know. Like you said, Jack the Ripper. I don't know. L might come out the blue. Like, you can't put it past him. You know, he's passionate. That's somebody that's passionate like about his rap and his work.
Freddie Gibbs get this nominee. You know, he might hit him with some crazy shit, bro.
We're not doing no L new shit. No, no, no. Phenomenon, head sprung, Ashanti in the water. We're not doing none of that bullshit. No, no.
Come out. This has been the latest episode of the GCP Gladiator Cypher Podcast, a Head Cannon Circus production.
Condom when we do the show,
huh?
That's a bulletproof condom when we do the show, man.
We gotta have a graphic fly across the screen.
Condom, what's those?
what was the Ari Lennox belts? I thought
about new season packets. I ain't never seen. What's that? You doing those?
What you say? Chicken, beef, shrimp?
Yeah. Chicken and beef.
Oh my goodness! Everybody, make sure you like, subscribe, follow, share, comment. On all of the Gladiator Cypher podcast posts across all your various social media channels. We got a presence on Facebook, Instagram, soon to be Twitter. So we'll be looking forward to that back and forth with our fans. Definitely want to see you guys engage with the posts and let us know your thoughts. Let us know what kind of music you've been listening to. We'll be crazy for our takes today with the Watch the Throne scoring. You know, just give us what you're feeling. But we'll be back with you next week, dropping Tuesday. Some more hotness for you. Hopefully you get some good music drop. See you next week. Stay tuned. And remember, join the circus.
I'm still saying, I'm still strong.
Uh.